Dear learners, welcome to this session of marketing research. In earlier sessions, we gained familiarity with the meaning, nature, importance, scope, and applications of marketing research. We have taken the case of organic fruit and vegetable seller, Mr. Mohan, who was struggling to sell his organic products. With the help of this case situation, we discuss the scope of marketing research, which includes all the functions of marketing management. We have further discussed that applications of marketing research can be broadly classified as problem identification research or problem solving research. The purpose of problem identification research is to find problems that may not be immediately obvious but are still present or likely to occur in the future, such as to know the market potential of any product or service, sales forecasting, market share analysis, and so on. Whereas problem solving research is done to find a solution. Findings from this research are then used in making decisions. Decisions related to specific marketing problems, such as segmentation, targeting, positioning, and other marketing mix strategies. We have also discussed that marketing information revolves around the four C's. These C's are customer, competitor, company, and cost. So, marketing research focuses on these four C's and supports the overall management of the marketing function. However, when deciding which functional areas to pursue for marketing research, a marketing manager has to give priority to the most urgent and significant issues. In this session, we will discuss the status of marketing research in India. More specifically, we shall explore why marketing research is becoming important in India and what the major challenges are faced by marketing researchers in India. The learning outcomes of this session are, first is, describe the growing market research industry in India. The second is, know ways of conducting marketing research in India. Then, appreciate the role of new technologies and digital marketing research in India. The one learning outcome is, assess adoption of marketing research by Indian businesses and examine challenges of conducting marketing research in India. We can characterize the growing Indian market research industry by understanding the global and Indian context of the marketing research industry. Then we can say how revenue distribution is structured within the Indian market research industry. Then what are the major sectors within the industry and what factors driving its growth and the increasing use of outsourcing in Indian marketing research. Now, let us see the global and Indian scenario of marketing research industry. The global market research industry is a large and mature industry of around $74 billion. The United States is the largest market, followed by India, China, and Japan. The Indian market research industry is growing rapidly and is expected to reach $10 billion by 2030. From revenue distribution point of view, the Indian market research industry is increasingly focused on marketing analytics services, and this accounted for 52% of the total industry revenue in financial year 2021. This reflects the growing importance of data-driven decision-making in businesses. Traditional market research and syndicated or publishing services are still important with 32% and 16% share respectively. But their share of the market is expected to decline. From the perspective of key sectors in the Indian market research industry, the FMCG and retail sectors are the largest users of market research services. And these both FMCG and retail sectors accounts for 27% of research revenue. This is due to highly competitive nature of these sectors. Other important sectors include information, communications, and telecom with 16% share, followed by banking, financial services, and insurance with 15%. Several factors are driving the growth of Indian market research industry. These factors include telecommunication, disruptions, technological advancements, the emergence of the middle class, a young population familiar with global brands, and lower research expenses in India. Outsourcing is a major driver of growth in the Indian market research industry. 3/4 of Indian market research revenue comes from international outsourced market accounts because the cost of data processing is significantly lower in India than in developed countries. It is roughly 50% lower in India than in industrialized nations. India also has a large pool of qualified market research experts. So these factors make India a desirable destination for outsourcing market research projects. Now, we will see the main approaches to conducting market research and the different data collection methods used by marketing research companies in India. Companies have two main options for conducting market research. One is internal research, another is external research. Internal research is conducted by the company's own employees, typically from the sales and marketing departments. This approach is cost effective, but may lack the expertise of external research firms. Whereas the external research is conducted by marketing research companies, advertising agencies, or consultants. These are more expensive. External research offers greater expertise and access to specialized resources. Now, let us see advantages and disadvantages of internal and external research. Internal research offers several advantages, such as it is cost effective, as the company does not need to pay external fees. Additionally, internal research can be completed faster because employees already have a good understanding of the company and its products. However, internal research also has some disadvantages. Employees may lack the expertise in research methodology to conduct a rigorous study. They may also be biased towards existing company beliefs, leading to inaccurate results. Finally, employees may not have the resources or time to dedicate to a comprehensive research project. Similarly, external research offers several advantages over internal research. Marketing research firms have the expertise in research methodology to design and conduct a valid and reliable study. They can also provide an unbiased perspective, free from any existing company biases. Additionally, marketing research firms have access to specialized resources such as large databases and advanced data analyst tools. However, external research also has some disadvantages. It is typically more expensive than internal research, and the turnaround time may be longer as the research firm needs to understand the company's needs and objectives. Finally, external research firms may not have the same level of familiarity with the company and its products as internal employees. So, by knowing the advantages and disadvantages of internal and external research, now let us discuss main data collection methods used in Indian marketing research. The most common data collection method utilized by marketing research companies in India is interviews. These interviewing techniques are among the top 10 commonly used methods and include in-depth interviews, computer-assisted telephonic interviews, that is CATI, computer-assisted personal interview, that is CAPI, paper and pencil interview, PAPI, and face-to-face interviews. Focus groups, internet surveys, desk research, mystery shopping, and recruiting are additional frequently used methods. Some businesses also use panels and ethnographic methods. The interview method encompasses various techniques to cater to different research needs. In-depth interviews provide a platform for in-depth exploration of a specific subject with a single participant. Computer-assisted telephonic interviews, CATI, offers a cost-effective way to reach a geographically dispersed audience through phone interviews with the help of computer software. Computer-assisted personal interviews, CAPI, facilitates face-to-face interactions but leverages a computer for question presentation and data entry, enhancing efficiency. Paper and pencil interviews, PAPI, the traditional method, involves paper questionnaires for data collection. Lastly, face-to-face interviews allow for rapport building with participants and observations of non-verbal cues, providing valuable context to responses. While interviews are widely used, other methods play a crucial role in market research. One is focus groups that brings together a small, diverse group for interactive discussions, generating rich qualitative data. Online surveys allow researchers to reach a large audience quickly and efficiently, gathering quantitative data on a broader scale. Desk research involves leveraging existing data source to gain background knowledge and context for the primary research conducted through interviews or other methods. Mystery shopping provides valuable insights into the customer service experience by developing trained individuals to evaluate interactions with service personnel. The ranking of various interviewing methods used in marketing research studies in India are shown in Table 1. The share of in-depth interview is ranked 1. The second one is the focus group. Online survey is ranked as number 3. CATI, computer-assisted telephonic interviews, is ranked as 4. In fifth, desk research, and CAPI, computer-assisted personal interviews, is ranked as 6. Mystery shopping as 7. Recruiting as 8. And PAPI, paper and pencil interviews, is ranked at 9. And face-to-face interviews is ranked at number 10. Now, let us see the types of research services offered by marketing research companies in India. Marketing research companies offer a variety of services to their clients. The most common type of service is data collection and processing. This includes tasks such as conducting surveys, interviews, and focus groups, as well as cleaning and coding the collected data. Report writing is another common service where the research firm takes the analyzed data and presents it in a clear and concise report for the client. Additionally, marketing research firms may offer services such as data analysis, survey design and sampling, and data visualization. The ranking of marketing research services for specific projects in India is shown in Table 2. Data analysis and processing is ranked at number 1, data collection at number 2, report writing at number 3, survey programming at number 4, data entry and tabulation at number 5, open-ended coding at number 6, data cleaning and validation at number 7, transcription at number 8, questionnaire design at number 9, and the multivariate analysis are ranked at number 10. One more type of research services offered is known as syndicated research, in which market research firms conduct studies on industry trends that multiple businesses might find valuable. They design the research and sell the results in the form of reports, presentations, or raw data to anyone interested. This can be a way to attract new clients or gain recognition within an industry. Some research companies gather ongoing marketing data and provide regular reports to subscribers on weekly, monthly, or quarterly basis. These reports are useful for various market areas, such as tracking things like consumer buying habits through retail audit, medication use through prescription audit, TV viewership through television rating points, and newspaper or magazine readership through NRS. They can also analyze market potential in specific areas, such as cities with over 1 lakh people, and study broader consumer trends through national attitude and psychographic studies. So, with this, now we will discuss digital marketing research in India, how the increasing internet and smartphone presentation has transformed the way market research is conducted in the country. The rise of digital marketing research is a major trend that is transforming the Indian market research industry. New technologies are making it possible to gather data more quickly, accurately, and cheaply. These technologies are also providing researchers with deeper insights into consumer behavior. As a result, Indian businesses are better positioned than ever before to understand their customers and make data-driven decisions. India's digital landscape has grown rapidly in recent years. India has the world's second largest internet user base, with over 843 million users in 2021. This figure is expected to reach 1.5 billion by 2040. Smartphone usage is vastly outpaced the use of desktop and laptop usage, and smartphones are now present in 84% of households in India. The growth of smartphone and internet users has created a wealth of opportunities for market researchers. The benefits of digital marketing research is that it offers a number of advantages over traditional methods. The first advantage is that it is more cost-effective than traditional methods. Second, it allows researchers to reach a wider audience of respondents, and it provides access to a richer set of data. Social media can also be used to gather real-time insights from customers. New technologies such as artificial intelligence and machine learning are expected to provide substantial opportunities and play a major role in the future of marketing research. Artificial intelligence and machine learning can be used to analyze large amounts of data and identify patterns that would be difficult for human to see. Virtual reality and augmented reality can be used to create realistic simulations of products and services. Virtual environments can be used for product concept testing, early stage product feasibility analysis, and understanding consumer behavior. New technologies can be used for online qualitative research and social listening for a detailed understanding of the market and customers. Combining the capabilities of real-time research with agile market research could result in a comprehensive perspective of a consumer's past, present, and future habits at the rate at which they change. Technology-enabled techniques of the marketing research includes mobile surveys, online communities, social media analytics, text analytics, big data analytics, webcam-based interviews, eye tracking, facial analysis, then mobile qualitative, mobile ethnography, and micro surveys. It also includes the research, gamification, crowdsourcing, neuromarketing, biometric responses, and so on. So we can say that the future of marketing research in India is bright. New technologies such as artificial intelligence, machine learning, virtual reality, and augmented reality are poised to revolutionize the way market research is conducted. These technologies will allow researchers to gather data more quickly and accurately, and to gain deeper insights into consumer behavior. Now, let us see the adoption of marketing research by Indian businesses. The Indian market is undergoing a significant change. India is transforming from a seller's market to a buyer's market. This means that consumers have more choices and more bargaining power. As a result, competition is increasing in the Indian market. In addition, consumer behavior is rapidly changing. Consumers are more informed and more demanding than ever before. Given the changing market conditions in India, marketing research is becoming increasingly important. Marketing research helps businesses to understand their target market, develop new products and services, price their products and services competitively, develop effective marketing campaigns, and also it helps in measuring the effectiveness of their marketing efforts. All of these factors can contribute to businesses' success in the Indian market. Types of marketing research used in India was explored by Segal and Min. They found that Indian companies most commonly request customer satisfaction surveys, followed by advertising research and market segmentation research. Other popular services include research on usage and attitude, consumers in general, concepts and products, brands and pricing, tracking customer trends. Ranking of types of marketing research used in India explored by Segal and Min is shown in table 3, where the consumer or customer satisfaction and loyalty survey was ranked as number 1, advertising research at number 2, segmentation research at number 3, usage and attitude at 4, consumer research at 5, concept testing was ranked at number 6, product testing at number 7, brand research in general was ranked at number 8, pricing research at number 9, and tracking study at number 10. Many specialized and variety of unique services are offered by Indian marketing research companies, but consulting services stands out as the most popular option with rank 1. This consulting services covers a wide range including market analysis, competitor insights, brand management, pricing strategies, product development, social media listening, and overall business strategy along with customer segmentation. Retail audits comes in second rank. Social research is the other common specialized research service offered by Indian marketing research companies and ranked at number 3. Additional audit categories such as inventory checks, audits for multi-brand stores, accessibility audits, mystery audits, image measurements, brand perception, etc. Are ranked at 4th position. These rankings are shown in table 4. So various types of marketing research are widely used by Indian industries. However, there are a number of reasons why some businesses in India avoid marketing research. Some businesses believe that marketing research is too expensive and that the time and money could be better spent on other activities. Other businesses are content with the market information they receive from intermediaries such as wholesalers and retailers. Some businesses may also be skeptical of the value of marketing research, believing that it is not a guaranteed solution to business problems. Finally, even when companies embrace marketing research, they understand it should inform decisions. The decisions cannot replace by these research findings. Now let us see the rules for conducting effective marketing research in India. There are a number of important rules to follow when conducting marketing research in India. First, it is important to speak the language of your target market. India has 22 official languages and hundreds of dialects. So researchers should be able to communicate with the different groups effectively. Second, it is important to avoid literal translation of your research materials, a local translation partner can help you to ensure that your research materials are culturally appropriate and easy to understand. Third, it is important to respect the culture of your target market. Cultural factors can have a significant impact on how people respond to marketing research questions. Fourth, while modern technology can be a valuable tool for marketing research, it is important not to rely on it too heavily. Managerial expertise is still needed to interpret the data collected through marketing research. Fifth, watch out for signs of fraud, such as interviewers who regularly ask straight lining questions or direct candidates along with quickest routes to success. So with these rules for conducting effective marketing research in India, now we will discuss the key challenges faced when conducting marketing research in India. Due to its size and diversity, India presents unique challenges for marketing research. These issues include cultural diversity, population size and diversity, language barriers, accessibility issues, infrastructural issues, and value perception. Because of India's diverse cultural heritage, researchers need to take regional differences into consideration. To guarantee proper data gathering, a national survey needs to take these variations into account. The sheer size and demographic diversity of India necessitated dividing the country into numerous districts for national surveys. This approach can be costly and resource intensive for small and medium-sized businesses. With 22 official languages and several dialects, India's linguistic landscape makes translating survey research necessary for a thorough study. It can be particularly challenging to translate technical words accurately across regions, which could affect the comparability of the finding. Reaching India's vast rural population, which is growing faster than urban areas, presents a significant challenge. The other challenges are hyper-localization, low literacy rates, and the marketing research companies in India requires data from multiple cities with distinct cultural and linguistic features to conduct nationwide studies. High cost associated with such comprehensive research can be challenging to justify to clients who may not appreciate the value. One challenge is tend to offer lower compensation by the marketing researchers. This low pay scale lead to a high turnover rate among market research professionals, making it difficult to retain highly skilled researchers. Other problem is the reliability of secondary data, as well as the one challenge is to sampling design. The absence of proper sampling frames, which are critical for random sampling techniques, poses a challenge for market research in India. Researchers are forced to rely on non-probability sampling methods, which can negatively impact. So we can conclude that there will always be a need for skilled market researchers. Despite these challenges, technology will change the field, but researchers will still be needed to find insights. In order to effectively use technology, the research teams in the future will integrate technical and problem-solving skills. India has the potential to be a profitable market research partner due to its highly skilled and productive research workforce. So in this session, we have covered the scenario of marketing research in India, ways of conducting marketing research in India, digital marketing research in India, adoption of marketing research by Indian businesses, challenges of conducting marketing research in India. So with this, we can end the session. Thank you. Thank you very much.